All right. So Saturday night had a lot of memorable moments in Las Vegas, some good, some really bad. And the latter has to do with a main card bout that took place in the 205-pound division featuring this man, Mike Rodriguez, who took on Ed Herman. It looked as if he finished the fight in the second round after a couple of brutal knees to the body. Unfortunately, referee Chris Tione thought he saw a low blow, and it ended with Ed Herman picking up this crazy submission in the third round. But happy to be joined by Mike Rodriguez right now, less than 48 hours removed from that crazy turn of events. Hi, Mike. How are you, man?
I'm good, man. I'm good.
I like the subtle shirt wearing with the diamond cup and the May shirt.
I had to drop it.
Nicely played. But we'll get into the chaos in a moment. But I just want to say I thought you looked outstanding in the fight on Saturday night. I'd say it was your best performance in the UFC, no doubt about it. But on our preview show on Friday, one of the things I was intrigued about in this fight was, because of Ed's durability, how things would look if it got out of the first round into the second round, maybe into the third round. Second round, you look sensational. You look better in the second round than you did in the first round. How did it feel to, I know the result didn't turn out the way you wanted, but how did it sort of feel to answer those questions about your cardio, the longevity of these fights? Because getting out of the first round, it seemed like you were even getting even stronger as the fight went on.
Yeah, I knew, well, first things first, like, we knew he was durable as hell. We knew that. I hit him with a shot. I know I hit him with that elbow in the first round. So that was playing in my mind that I already had hit him with that shot. So I'm like, all right, cool. When we go into the second round, let's turn it up. So Mays, my boxing coach, he's always talking about going into that second gear as the rounds go on, going that second gear. So, you know, I just started putting the pressure on him. And I don't know if I told you in an interview, but I wanted a second round finish. So, you know, I wanted to attack that body some more. I did some damage to it already in the first round, and I just wanted to keep pressing on it in the second. And I thought I had the Holy Grail. I thought I hit it. I thought it was over in a second. But, that was the whole game plan, and I just executed the game plan.
Because you've been watching Ed compete for years and years. You watched him in high school on The Ultimate Fighter, and you knew how tough he was. Were you even more surprised with his durability in the fight? Did it actually exceed your expectations?
Yeah, there was one point I'm thinking of fight. I'm like, holy hell, I hit this dude with everything. How is he still standing? And he was still there, man. He was still there. But I kind of got in the mindset of like, no offense to him, but like heavy bag, like just hitting a heavy bag. Just hit him. Just place it there, place things there. And that's how I just kept doing it. Just kept. Because after that, I hit him with that elbow. I thought it could have been done there. Honestly, but nah, man, he was still in that fight.
I don't know how he recovered from that, but
yeah,
let's just get address the elephant in the room. Let's get into the moments everybody wants to know about. So Edge, what surprised me about the fight is Ed chose to spend a lot of time in the clinch, especially since your last fight went so well for you in the clinch. But so for those who don't know, I'm sure you all know by now, but you have his back against the cage. You're landing. You land a pair of nasty knees to the body. The second one drops him to the mat, and you're getting ready to finish the fight. And Chris Tione steps in to seemingly stop it, and you're getting ready to celebrate. And Chris calls time, and you question. You're like, time? What are you talking about? Yeah. He says, he just yells out the word nuts, and Ed takes the allotted time. What the hell is going on in your mind at this moment? I assume you're watching the replay over and over again like the rest of us. What is happening in your mind at this point?
So first of all, Tim, like, I'm a good sport. I don't want to be known as like a cheater or anything. So one of my teammates, Ross Levine, we did rounds for the Petrino fight, and I hit him in that same exact way. And I hit him in the balls twice, back to back in sparring. So I'm like, so I just instantly, when he said nuts, I instantly had a recap of that. And I'm like, oh, you know, yeah, it could have been. And so I'm sitting back. I'm like, you know, my bad or whatever. Then something told me to look up at the screen because my corner was like, this is bullshit, blah, blah, blah. And I'm like, all right, cool. I look at the screen. I'm like, oh, that was all liver. And then I did get my emotions involved in it, that he was milking the clock. But then I was like, you know what? We got to fight. We're still fighting. Like, they're giving him 5 minutes. You take this 5 minutes. You rest. Calm your heart rate down. And let's get back in there. So I had to look at it as that. Like, the show must go on. Like, it's whatever, you know.
are you trying to talk to Chris at that moment? Are you saying like, dude, are you watching this replay right now? Like,
no, I didn't even say anything to him. I was just like, whatever, just keep moving. Like, I'll worry about, I'm like, I'll let my management and coaches and stuff deal with that afterwards. I gotta finish Ed. So that was like on my mind, is finish him in that round.
When there's a stop in the action like that, there can't be any coaching at all. And I know Joe Lozon is a pretty calm, cool, collected guy most of the time, but he's your coach. Yeah. I'm sure he's pretty irate. Steve Mays, as you mentioned, is in your corner. I met Steve years and years ago when I was like 18 years old. Yeah. I even went on Twitter. I'm like, I've met Steve Mays. He must be losing his mind right now. Oh, were they yelling at the referee?
They said something. I don't really remember, but, All I remember the coach saying in return, like, hey, stop coaching. They could have been possibly telling me something, like kick him there again or something. But yeah, they just was like, this is bullshit. Everybody was pissed about it. Everybody.
Steve's got that baseball background too. So, you know, it must be tough for him to like,
heard, because where I stopped that, Bisping was behind me. I even heard Bisping saying like, oh, Ed is milking this for all it's worth right now. Like, you know. But it sucked.
Yeah. I mean, Ed was badly hurt in that scenario. And even after the fight, when he spoke with Bisping, he admitted that he was hurt, but he even said like he didn't know whether it was a knee to the body or to the, how should I say this gracefully, the testicular region. So I'm curious, did you get where Ed was coming from? Like, do you respect what he did taking that time if he has the chance to recover? Or was there a part of you that lost a little respect for him there?
No, I mean, they gave him the time. Like, I mean, if you're like, you know what I'm saying? He was like, hey, you know, take five, whatever, and gave him his 5 minutes. So I'm assuming he took it. He was like, all right, yeah. Because we all knew it was like the beginning to the end, and he was able to get a free 5 minutes from being finished off. So he's like, oh, all right, sick. So it's whatever.
I mean, I thought you had it finished like right after that too. You landed a hard body kick like right away. You went back to the body. You drop him again. I thought it might have been a wrap there, but he survives. And then he goes for the takedown in the third round. You're landing that barrage of elbows a la Travis Brown. Like, what are you thinking about in these spots? Because, I mean, this had to have been the most emotional roller coaster of a fight in your entire career. Had to have been, right? I mean, what are you thinking?
So going into the third round, reason why I got caught by that Kimura is that I just wanted to finish him. I'm like, I gotta pour it on him. I was good. My energy was great. Gas tank was good. I'm like, we're gonna finish him right now. And so I just went out there and tried to put as much pressure on him and stuff like that. And which ended up resulting in me getting me finished. He, like a veteran move himself, like, you know, he put that Kimura in his pocket and grabbed it. It was good. That's what I wanted to do was finish him. I want to be on that list of guys that finished them. So
when he first starts to work for the Kimura, are you just thinking to yourself, there's no way he has the strength to pull this off right now. Like, there's just no way. And then he did. Like, it's just wild to watch.
It was wild. I'm like, he ain't gonna have it. Then what I was thinking about trying to do was I was going to post up on him while he was in that little crack of the cage and just start kneeing his body. And by time, like, the ADD mindset I got in here, got hold of it. And I'm like, oh yeah, let me get that. It was too late. He had that Kimura bite on me. And I was like, no. And I'm trying to fight it. And he just peeled it out and he got the sweep. And then I was kind of also like, after the fight, I didn't even know this after. Like, I was like, come on, Ed. Like, why would you do that to yourself? Like, he put his foot in the fence to get the sweep. And I'm like, dude, like, you did so good. Like, you got the win. Like, why would you do that? So that, like, kind of threw salt on his victory a little bit. I'm like, but that's whatever.
How is the arm? Because I know Dana addressed it in the post-fight press conference and said that your arm was okay. That was, like, the one thing he was really worried about. It was, like, guy gets screwed out of a win, and then he breaks his arm. I assume the arm's okay?
Yeah, the arm's okay. I could have strongmanned it, but I didn't want to break my shoulder at all. Like, I just didn't think the fight was even worth it, my shoulder getting broken. So I'm like, you know what? Nah, go ahead. Because, I want to fight soon, relatively soon, too. So I was like, all right, I'll let you have it. There you go.
I'll admit, and I am supposed to be the unbiased journalist here, I was pissed on Saturday night. And not just because you're a New England guy like myself. I would have been pissed for anybody in that situation. But it was just a heartbreaking thing to see. But the good news is the majority of the MMA community, as fickle as it can be, everybody had your back. Even Dana White slamming Chris Tione, said it was Steve Mazzagatti, like one of the worst things he's ever seen.
When I went into the back room and I saw a doctor, Dana was the first person I saw, the very first person. He was before Joe, anybody else. He came in, boom. So I was like, my head was down. The doc checked my shoulder. I'm like, man, it's whatever, blah, blah, blah. I looked up, Dana was right there. And he had this face, this red beef face. And I'm like, did I do something? I'm like, no, I didn't do anything. He was like, I am so pissed. This is one of the worst refereeing I ever seen. Blah, blah, blah. And he just started going off in this tangent. And I'm like, oh, all right. And then before I left, they was like, hey, he's still going to give you your win money. So I was like, oh, shit. Thank you. So, yeah.
Does it kind of soften the blow a little bit having Dana's support and everybody else's support? I mean, it sucks to have a loss next to your name right now, but does that at least make you feel a little bit better?
The more thing that I'm more excited about, that I'm happy about, is that everybody saw me perform and everybody loved my performance. That was the one thing that I really cared about. Everybody. Like, I haven't heard a single bad thing. Everybody's like, man, you was performing out of this world. You was on fire, blah, blah, blah. I even looked at my stats. I was like, 70% accuracy rate, like something like that. It was ridiculous. And I was like, oh, feels pretty good. So, yeah.
So immediately after all this unfolds, I text your manager, Tyson Chartier, and I'm like, what the F, man? What was that all about? And he goes, we're appealing this thing. So after Dana comes out and speaks to the media and says they're going to give you his win money, I'm like, all right, well, at least he's getting his win money. And he goes, yeah. I'm like, well, are you still going to appeal? And he said, yes, because he wants to make sure that in essence, what he said was the rules are enforced and improved in the sport and that you shouldn't have to go at like your Tapology page and see a loss next to your name. Are you happy with the fact that this is still getting appealed? And two, what are the chances that this gets overturned in your opinion? It's not like overturns haven't happened in the sport, but this is a pretty unique situation.
I think if it does get, I think it'll become an NC.
Yeah.
If it does, it does. It's whatever. I'm just already like, I'm just past it. I'm ready to go and fight again. Like, I'm already locked in my mind fight. I'm here with my wife. She's like, oh, like, why are you like pantsing around? I'm like, I'm still in fight week mode. Leave me alone. I'm still ready to fight, you know? So, yeah, I'm just trying to gear back up. So I'm going to do all the medical procedures, check everything out, make sure I'm good, and then get right back to another camp. Stop beefing again.
Do you feel like you won? Like, do you feel like you're sitting at home right now with the win under your belt, despite of what the record shows?
Yes. That's the weird thing about it. It's like, I feel like I won. Like, I don't, like, you know, like every fight I get those lost blues, didn't have them. Did not have them at all. I felt like amazing. I went back to the hotel and I was unpacking my stuff, running around the hotel suite with a beer and my boxers. It was great. I was fine. That was good.
What kind of beer did you go with? I mean, if it felt like a win, it's got to be a celebratory beer.
It was a local brewery out there, like Lamplight Brewery or something like that. I don't remember the name of the beer. It was pretty good. It was pretty good. But yeah, I was just hanging out.
Totally. So one of the things I kept seeing on social media, it was like most people had your back, and it seemed like the solution was to just run it back with Ed. Like, would you even want to run it back with him? Like, I don't know how motivated you would be for that, since you and many others felt that you dominated that fight. Would that even interest you?
Not really. No, I wouldn't. I mean, I already beat him. I beat him, you know? If the bosses was asking, like, oh, do you want to run it back to Ed, whatever, blah, blah, like, or if they was like, yo, we think that would be a good matchup, then yeah, I'll do it for being a company guy, but no, I think I'm over and done with it. It happened. But if you look at it, he won, which he did technically, but technically he didn't. So I don't know. I'm just moving on from the whole situation.
So what are you looking at now? Is there anybody that sticks out to you that you want to get back in there and try to get this taste out of your mouth?
The only thing that sticks out to me is getting cleared by the doctor. That's my fight right now. So let me get cleared by him. Then we can start looking at potential matchups and stuff.
Good to be home, though, right?
Oh, yeah. It's really good to be home.
Patriots won. Cam Newton era has begun. Celtics getting ready to crush the Heat. I mean, New England cartel's got a lot of momentum. A lot of good things going on.
A lot of good things. My man Paiva's fighting tomorrow. And Randy's on Saturday. It's a lot of good things.
Here we come. Here comes New England. Mike, I appreciate you coming on talking about this. I'm sure there's a million other things you'd rather be discussing right now than rehashing the chaos of Saturday night. But I'm sure you're probably gonna do more interviews about this, but what's sort of the message for everybody following Saturday night so you can start the process, or at least continue the process of putting this all behind you and moving forward here?
I would just say, you know, it happened. It was an awkward moment in our sport. We just accept it. Just move right along. Don't send Ed Herman no hate messages or anything. Please don't. He's a good dude. All he did was get an opportunity. He just capitalized on it. That was it. But yeah, that's it.
There you go. Thanks, Mike. I wish we were officially recapping a victory here, which I guess we kind of are in your opinion and most others, but you looked fantastic in the fight, and best of luck to you in the appeal and for whatever's next for you, man. I appreciate it.
Thank you, man. Thank you.